EBSB fraternity of both GNC College, a government college for women and dear students. I, Dr. Shelly Chen, extend a warm and inclusive welcome to you all on this platform created to take a small step towards realizing that larger goal of making Ek Bharat a Shreshth Bharat. The program is an excellent move of the government to weave the threads of various cultures, languages, traditions, and religions of different states of India into a strong and durable fabric. GNC takes pride that under EBSB program, it has been associated with one of the leading colleges of Telangana, the Government Degree College for Women, Pusanialam. And hope that the two colleges will be able to forge mutual understanding and appreciation through various cultural exchange programs as today's webinar. So not taking much time, let us begin the event by calling upon Dr. R.P. Singh, the program coordinator of EBSB Club, GNC College. R.P. ma'am, kindly take over and address everyone.
थैंक यू शैली मैम. आज इस मंच पर उपस्थित सभी बुद्धिजीवियों को मेरा सादर नमस्कार. मैं डॉक्टर आरती सिंह एक भारत श्रेष्ठ भारत दिवस के उपलक्ष में आयोजित इस वेबिनार में उपस्थित सभी प्राध्यापकों व विद्यार्थियों का स्वागत करती हूँ. मैं विशेष तौर पर गुरु नानक गर्ल्स कॉलेज की डायरेक्टर व आज के समारोह की विशिष्ट अतिथि डॉक्टर वरिंदर गांधी जी का स्वागत करती हूँ. साथ ही हमारे कॉलेज की प्राचार्य श्रीमती पूनम कौर आलूवालिया जी का व गवर्नमेंट डिग्री कॉलेज हुसैनी आलम की प्राचार्य एम वसुधा जी का बहुत बहुत स्वागत करती हूँ. साथ ही मैं मेरी सहयोगी गवर्नमेंट डिग्री कॉलेज फॉर विमेन तेलंगाना से मैडम असरा सुल्ताना जी का व गुरु नानक गर्ल्स कॉलेज व गवर्नमेंट डिग्री कॉलेज फॉर विमेन के एक भारत श्रेष्ठ भारत क्लब से हमारे साथ जुड़े मेरे सभी साथी प्राध्यापकों का इस मंच पर स्वागत करती हूँ. एक भारत श्रेष्ठ भारत मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ ह्यूमन रिसोर्स डेवलपमेंट गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया के द्वारा संचालित एक योजना है जिसका उद्देश्य भारतीयों में एकता व अखंडता की भावना को बढ़ाना है. इस योजना में निहित भाव बहुत ही गहरा है. मैं इसके उद्देश्य को एक उदाहरण से स्पष्ट करना चाहूँगी. जिस प्रकार एक बड़े परिवार के कुछ सदस्य यदि अपनी जीविका के कारण कहीं दूर जाकर रहने लगें तो बहुत वर्ष बीत जाने पर एक ही घर में रहने वाले सदस्यों के बीच अधिक स्नेह व लगाव होता है तथा दूर रहने वाले सदस्यों से मानसिक दूरी बन जाती है, परंतु सदस्य फिर भी एक ही परिवार से जुड़े होते हैं. यही स्थिति हमारे बहुत ही विशाल देश भारत रूपी परिवार की है. अलग अलग प्रदेशों में रहने वाले हम सभी सदस्य यह जानते हैं कि दूसरे प्रदेशों में हमारे ही भाई बहन रहते हैं, परंतु अपने अपने जीवन की व्यस्तताओं में उलझे रहने के कारण हम मानसिक दूरी का अनुभव करते हैं. एक भारत श्रेष्ठ भारत योजना ने हम सभी को एक दूसरे के विषय में जानने का बेहतरीन अवसर दिया है. मुझे बहुत खुशी है कि आज इस मंच पर दोनों महाविद्यालयों से छात्राएं व प्राध्यापक गण एकत्रित हुए हैं. दोनों ओर से विचारों का यह आदान प्रदान हम सभी को दूसरे प्रदेश के बारे में वहां की संस्कृति व जीवन शैली को समझने में मददगार साबित होगा. अब अधिक समय ना लेते हुए मैं एक बार फिर से आप सभी का इस मंच पर स्वागत करती हूँ और आज के इस कार्यक्रम के सफल संचालन की कामना करती हूँ. धन्यवाद. ओवर टू यू शैली मैम.
थैंक यू आरती मैम. बहुत ही खूबसूरत तरीके से आपने समझाया कि किस तरह से सारी इंडिया की स्टेट्स एक ही हैं, बट हाँ अलग अलग दूर दूर रहने के कारण कल्चर डिफरेंट, रिलीजन डिफरेंट. थैंक यू सो मच मैम. नाउ आई वुड लाइक टू कॉल अपॉन मैडम असरा सुल्ताना, the program coordinator of EBSB Club, Government Degree College for Women, to say a few words to the August gathering. Madam Asra.
Good morning to the director of GNG College, Varinder Gandhi, Madam, and respected principals of both the colleges, Dr. Vasudha and Mrs. Ahluwalia, and all the teaching staff members and dear students. I take this opportunity to express my pleasure that Mrs. Dr. Aarti Singh and I have made this platform for mutual exchange, and hope that our students contact with each other and make friendship, and we try to accomplish the goal of Ek Bharat Shreshth Bharat. Through this platform, we hope that the cultures of both the states come to the fore, and we get to know each other better, in a better manner. And I thank Aarti Madam also for guiding our students in joining this platform and making a presentation for this. And now I give a brief introduction of our college. Our college, Government Degree College for Women Husseini Alam, was established in the year 1984. It is a premier institution of higher education for women located in the heart of Old City of Hyderabad, in the vicinity of Charminar, Lad Bazaar and Chowmohalla Palace. The college was started with a meager strength of 100 students in Khurshid Jah Diori, which is the palace of Paiga Noble. It is a heritage structure now. The college made rapid progress in its growth and is now offering 14 UG courses with different combinations and 3 PG courses, MA, MSc and MCom. The student strength at present is around 1400. The college was shifted to a new building adjacent to the Diori in the year 2000. The college has 20 departments and 50 staff members, both teaching and non-teaching. Our college has been sanctioned a grant of rupees 4 crores under RUSA Component 5, which is a central government initiative and jointly funded by central and state governments for attaining higher levels of access, equity and excellence in state higher education system. Under this scheme, our college is one among the 3 colleges in Telangana state which were selected for upgradation to model degree colleges. Under RUSA funding, the college now has a new building for library and auditorium, and a 3rd floor has been added to the existing building for expansion purpose. New infrastructure has also been purchased under the RUSA scheme. The college is affiliated to Usmania University. I am proud to say that the overall result of the college exceeds the overall average result of the university every year. We have the record of producing university toppers in various subjects. The excellent results are due to the hard work of our wonderful students, untiring efforts of our dedicated staff, and efficient administration and wholehearted support of our principal. The college also has a Telangana Skills and Knowledge Center, TSKC, which looks after career guidance, personality development, and soft skills of the students. It offers training classes to the students, as a result of which our students are placed in MNCs and many have joined state government jobs. Our students also present Mana TV TSAT programs in student as teacher programs in various subjects. They take part in research projects under Jignasa scheme. Our students also has excelled in sports and won many a laurel for us. They take part in cultural activities in Yuva Tarangam program also. With this short brief of our college, I stop now and hand over to the anchor. And ma'am, please continue. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Astra ma'am. Thank you so much. Now, I request our respected principal, GNG College, Mrs. Poonam Kaur Ahluwalia, to kindly take over the platform and welcome all our guests and students. Ma'am, please. Aarti ma'am, is Poonam ma'am connected with us?
Let me check, ma'am.
Okay.
शैली मैम,
जी
पूनम मैम
मैम,
टेक्निकल रीजन से डिसकनेक्ट हो गए हैं. शी इज़ ट्राइंग टू कनेक्ट. सो
ओके
आई सजेस्ट मीन वाइल यू कैन इनवाइट प्रिंसिपल
ओके
GDCW.
फाइन फाइन ओके. नाउ आई मोस्ट हम्बली रिक्वेस्ट रिस्पेक्टेड प्रिंसिपल गवर्नमेंट डिग्री कॉलेज फॉर वुमेन डॉक्टर एम वसुधा टू काइंडली से अ फ्यू वर्ड्स एंड एड ऑन द प्लेटफॉर्म. मैम प्लीज.
Can you see me?
Yes, yes, ma'am, we can.
Where is it that I can't see myself?
We can see you and hear you as well, ma'am.
Thank you. Thank you. Yeah, just a second. Okay. Namaskar and Adab from Hyderabad. Government Degree College Hussaini Alam, as Asra Madam has already told you, all of you. Is located in the old city. I think madam did not tell you this, that most of our students are Muslim girls, and we cater to the people from the old city. It's not that we don't take students from other cities, but our catchment area is the old city, and a lot of the girls are Muslim girls, and it's a culture of old Hyderabad. Hyderabad is a very old city, and so our girls are so you will learn a lot about Hyderabadi culture from them, and I hope, sincerely hope, that our girls also will be exposed to Haryanvi culture. And you know, in the beginning when I heard about the Ek Bharat Shreshth Bharat program, the first thought that came to me was that, oh my God, not another program which we have to do and have to make the girls do. But I think now I am really, really, I think it's a wonderful program, and I hope both students from both sides get to know each other, not just you know, on a formally on this basis, but make friends, understand what a wonderful country India is. You know, even the distance separates us, there is so much that we can learn from each other, especially now, since the education system itself is undergoing so many changes. We are at a crossroads. We don't know where we are going. We don't know when we are going to go back to college. We don't know how much is going to happen. I mean, how things are going to go from here. I think now is the time that we should think about how well we can integrate with each other, learn how to deal with various problems. Like being an urban city, Hyderabad is seeing a lot, and since there are people are chock-a-block and almost live one on top of each other. The disease, the COVID-19, is spreading like anything. So, I mean, that is because it is an urban area. I don't know. I wish I knew more about Yamuna Nagar. I don't know if it is a town or it's set in a rural setting. I would like to know more about that. And I have visited Haryana only as far as Gurugram, actually. So I do, you know, I was looking forward to being able to travel to Haryana and you know, see along with the girls, through the eyes of my girls. And I hope in the next, I think, 2 years in which we are partner states, we learn more about each other and the students are able to contribute for the development, integration, and learning of the country. Thank you. I think with these few words, I'd like to stop. Thank you very much to the principal of Guru Nanak Girls College, the director and the management. Thank you, Dr. Aarti. Thank you to all the staff and students for being here and partnering with our state. I also wish to thank my own staff, students, and especially Asra Madam for putting together this webinar. I hope in the webinars to come, we share not only our cultures, we learn more about our cultures, but also about how we together can develop the country. Thank you. Namaskar.
Thank you so much, ma'am. And we assure you that by the end of 2 years, you'll be able to know every bit of Haryana. We make sure of that. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Now, I request our respected principal, GNG College, Mrs. Poonam Kaur Ahluwalia, to kindly take over the platform and welcome all our guests and students. Ma'am, please.
Thank you, Dr. Shelley. Respected Director, ma'am, of GNG College, Dr. Varinder Gandhiji, Principal, Women Degree College for Women, Telangana, Dr. M. Vasudhaji, distinguished teachers from Government PG College, Chandigarh, and other colleges of Telangana, teacher members of Ek Bharat, Shreshth Bharat of both the colleges, and dear students, a very good morning to you all. I, on behalf of GNG College, extend a warm and hearty welcome to you all to this webinar on Know Your Paired State. Ek Bharat, Shreshth Bharat is a great initiative by Honorable Prime Minister Shri Narendra Modi ji to enable people of different states to celebrate cultural diversity of India through mutual interaction. It's a matter of great pleasure and honor for GNG to be paired under this program of Ek Bharat, Shreshth Bharat with Government Degree College for Women, Hussaini Alam, Telangana, for this mutual reciprocity. This is a great opportunity for us to know and see the social customs, food, culture, traditions, faiths, beliefs, and heritage of Telangana through the eyes of our allied colleges. We appreciate and value this collaboration and hope that the interaction of the two colleges through the events as today's will go a long way in making the decisions of both sides culturally bonded and integrated. Once again, I welcome each one of you and wish you all an enjoyable time. Thank you. I hope you enjoy the webinar. Over to Shelley, ma'am.
Thank you. Thank you so much, ma'am. Now, I take an opportunity to request our honorable guest, the director, GNG College, Dr. Varinda Gandhi, to grace the event with her kind words. Ma'am, please.
Good afternoon, everyone. It is with immense pleasure that I welcome you all on this virtual platform to share and exchange the varied colors and fragrances of our respective state cultures. A very cordial welcome to Dr. M. Vasudha, Principal, Government Degree College. A warm welcome to all the teachers and students from the colleges of Chandigarh and Telangana. We all are bound by our commitment towards our mother country. And through this webinar, we are going to exhibit the spirit of unity in diversity. My heart goes out to the students who will today explore and learn about each other's cultures. Students, you are the future of our nation, and it is pertinent that you must imbibe the values of tolerance and respect for each citizen of India, irrespective of the caste, religion, or region. It is with this view only that our Honorable Prime Minister Shri Narendra Modi ji has initiated this Ek Bharat Shreshth Bharat program. It is indeed a matter of great joy for Guru Nanak Girls College family to be paired with Government Degree College for Women, both being women colleges, which is one of the leading colleges of Telangana. I am sure that this webinar will help us know each other better and will replenish our hearts with the beauty of cultural diversity. Before mapping the cultural trajectory of our state, Haryana, let me take this opportunity to introduce Guru Nanak Girls College to you in brief. Our college was established by the great visionary and philanthropist, Sant Pandit Nischal Singh Ji Maharaj, in 1973. With a vision to educate the daughters of the nation. The steadfast pursuit of excellence has led the college to carve an exclusive niche for itself in the state of Haryana. With the highest CGPA score of 3.10 in the district, Yamunanagar, awarded by NAC, the college takes pride in being one of the foremost women colleges of the state. Affiliated to Kurukshetra University, Kurukshetra, the college has consistently been providing quality education in varied streams like humanities, science, commerce, information technology, biotechnology, computer science, mass communication, and multimedia. Keeping in view the skill-oriented educational requirements, various vocational courses are also offered to the students. We offer 39 UG courses, 14 PG courses, and 9 career-oriented courses to cater to the present-day necessity and demand of the skill development-based education. We also have 2 courses, Web Designing and Beauty and Wellness, under the scheme of Community College of University Grants Commission. Ours is the only college under Kurukshetra University which offers a 4-year integrated BA B.Ed, BSc B.Ed course. With these words, I once again extend a hearty welcome to all of you. Wish you all a beautiful and fruitful time ahead. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you so much, ma'am. We are going to start with our core program, where the talented students from both the colleges, through their presentations, will take all of us on the cultural rides of Haryana and Telangana. So buckle up everyone and welcome our first participant, who is Disha, a student of GNG College. She will be delivering a speech on culture of Haryana. Disha, over to you now.
Good morning, everyone. I am Disha, a first year student of GNG. Today I am going to deliver a speech which will reflect various aspects of Haryanvi culture so that my Telangana friends get a glimpse of it. So here Disha, I go.
Excuse me, Disha, please rotate your phone. Yeah, it's better now. Yeah. I request all the students not to present their screens in between when someone is speaking or giving the presentation. When please don't share your screens.
Good morning, everyone. I am Disha, a first year student of GNG. Today I am going to deliver a speech which will reflect various aspects of Haryanvi culture so that my Telangana friends get a glimpse of it. So here I go. Haryana's culture is reflective of its folklore. Haryana is one of the wealthiest states in India and is one of the most economically developed regions in South Asia, popularly known as the home of gods. This vibrant state has a bountiful culture, heritage festivals, folklores, and a vibrant landscape. Along with a mesmerizing architecture and many tourist attractions, Haryana has gained a lot of fame for the lively fairs organized here. The most acclaimed of these are, the first one is Suraj Kund International Fair. ये जो फेयर है वो एवरी ईयर फरीदाबाद में सेटअप किया जाता है एंड दिस फेयर इज बेसिकली फॉर द आर्ट एंड क्राफ्ट एंड हैंडलूम लवर्स. दिस फेयर ब्यूटीफुली पोर्ट्रेज आर रूरल कल्चर, रूरल एरिया का कल्चर बहुत ब्यूटीफुली ये फेयर है. इस फेयर में वहाँ का कल्चर, वहाँ के आर्ट एंड क्राफ्ट को प्रेजेंट किया जाता है. बहुत सारे एम्यूजमेंट राइड्स, फूड कोर्ट्स लगते हैं एंड ऑल ओवर द वर्ल्ड बहुत सारे लोग इस फेयर को देखने आते हैं एंड एंजॉय करते हैं. द नेक्स्ट वन इज मैंगो मेला. मैंगो मेला इज ऑर्गेनाइज्ड इन द मंथ्स ऑफ जून एंड जुलाई इन पिंजोर. ये जो मेला है, दिस मेला इज बेसिकली फॉर ऑल द मैंगो लवर्स. वहाँ पे सिर्फ मैंगो की बहुत सारी वैरायटी नहीं आती ऑल ओवर इंडिया. यहाँ पे फार्मर्स को ये भी सिखाया जाता है कि वो अपनी प्रोडक्शन को कैसे रेज कर सकते हैं बाय यूजिंग आवर लेटेस्ट टेक्नोलॉजी. And now I am going to tell about the festivals of Haryana. To celebrate various occasions and events, a number of vibrant festivals take place in Haryana. These festivals include Tej, Gugga, Navami, Gita Janti. So, बहुत famous festival है यहाँ का, वो है Tej. The festival is celebrated with great pomp and enthusiasm all over the state. And this festival is usually celebrated on the third day of Shravan month. इस फेस्टिवल में गर्ल्स जो हैं वो अपने हाथों पर मेहंदी अप्लाई करती हैं एंड यंग गर्ल्स एंड वुमेन के ड्रेस्ड अप इन कलरफुल एंड वाइब्रेंट क्लोथ्स एंड एंगेज इन डांसिंग एंड सिंगिंग थ्रू आउट द इवनिंग. एंड नाउ आई एम गोइंग टू टेल अबाउट द आर्ट एंड क्राफ्ट ऑफ आवर स्टेट. लाइक एवरी स्टेट, हमारे स्टेट का भी बहुत डिफरेंट फॉर्म है आर्ट एंड कल्चर. बहुत सारे फॉर्म के यहाँ पे डांस, म्यूजिक, पोएट्री, एम्ब्रॉयडरी, पेंटिंग, वीविंग, स्कल्पटिंग है. Apart from being the major source of income for the craftsmen, these art forms are a super hit among tourists. जो handicrafts हैं, सिर्फ वो यहाँ के लिए एक major source of income नहीं है, बल्कि ये जो भी all over world यहाँ पे tourists आते हैं, उनके बीच में center of attraction की तरह है. Like any other region in India, Haryana also has its traditional form of dance and music, which is quite popular among people from all over the globe. बहुत ट्रेडिशनल फॉर्म्स हैं यहाँ डांस की, जिसमें इंक्लूड है घूमर कोरिया डांस. हरियाणा का जो फोक म्यूजिक है वो टू टाइप्स का है, क्लासिकल एंड कंट्री साइड. द क्लासिकल फॉर्म बिलोंग्स टू ग्रेट लेजेंड्स, वाइल कंट्री साइड म्यूजिक इंक्लूड्स सॉन्ग्स विद वेरिड रागास संग इन हिंदुस्तानी स्टाइल. ऑल्सो बहुत डिफरेंट तरह के इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स भी यूज किए जाते हैं इन सब फॉर्म्स को बजाने के लिए. ढोलक, ड्रम, मटका, हारमोनियम, सारंगी are played during the singing and dancing festivals. Haryana ki jo shawls hain, shawls bhi bahut famous hain because of their rich embroidery. Bahut sundar embroidery hoti hai, fulkari, jo ye shawls ko bahut hi zyada beautiful banati hai. और इन शॉल्स की डिमांड पूरे वर्ल्ड में है. नाउ आई एम गोइंग टू टेल अबाउट द ट्रेडिशनल ड्रेस ऑफ हरियाणा. द वाइब्रेंसी ऑफ द पीपल ऑफ हरियाणा इज क्वाइट एविडेंट इन देयर लाइफस्टाइल टू. द सिंप्लिसिटी एंड स्पिरिटेड एंथुसियाज्म फाइंड एक्सप्रेशन इन देयर वे ऑफ ड्रेसिंग अप. वुमेन ऑफ हरियाणा शो अ स्पेशल स्पेशल एफिसिटी towards colors. Their basic clothes include daman, kurti and chundar. So chundar hai wo ek long colored piece of cloth hai with shiny laces and beautiful motifs. Ye usually use kiya jata hai head ko cover karne ke liye aur upper area ko cover karne ke liye hai. Kurti is a shirt like blouse and the daman is a flary ankle long skirt with a धोती क्लोथ टक्ड इन बिटवीन द लेग्स विद अ व्हाइट कलर कुर्ता वॉर्न ऑन टॉप ऑफ इट. सिर पर वो पगड़ी पहनते हैं. पगड़ी इज द ट्रेडिशनल हेड गियर फॉर मैन विच इज नाउ वॉर्न मेनली बाय द ओल्ड विलेजर्स. जो व्हाइट अटायर है वो मैन का स्टेटस सिंबल है. From its ancient art form to their traditional clothing and earthly lifestyle, we have a lot to gain from this enriching society. Thank you.
Very nice, Disha. I think you have given a nice overview of Haryana and its food, and its dress, music, etc. Now I call upon our next participant, Mubeen Sultana from Government Degree College for Women. She will give her presentation on history of Telangana. Mubeen, are you there? Mubeen, can you please listen me?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, are you ready?
Yes, ma'am, ready. I'm ready.
Okay, okay.
Mubeen, you are requested to please turn on your camera also. Yes, Shelly, ma'am.
Yeah, I'm just asking, is her presentation, have you started displaying her presentation?
Yeah, presentation is there on the screen.
Okay, fine. Over to you, Mubeen.
Yes, ma'am. Good afternoon. I am Mubeen Sultana of BA final year. Telangana history. To begin with, Telangana its existing form was born on 2nd June 2015 as the 29th and the youngest state in the Union of India, as things stand today. Ancient Telangana up to 1000 BCE. The archaeological department under the Nizams of government has done tremendous work in discovering the traces of prehistorical human habitation in Telangana. These studies found that human habitation in parts of Telangana can be seen from the Paleolithic ages consistently. People continued to live and develop through the later stages of Mesolithic, Neolithic, and Metal ages. The Satavahanas. The Satavahanas or Sudavahanas, also referred to as the Andras in Puranas, were an ancient Indian dynasty based in Deccan region. The Kakatiyas. This dynasty ruled around 950 AD. The kingdom saw powerful kings like Ganpati Deva, Rudra Deva, and Pratapa Rudra, as well as the first ever woman ruler in subcontinent, Sudrama Devi. Qutub Shahis. Sultan Quli Qutub Shah, Subedar for Telangana under the Bahmanis with Golconda as his capital, declared his independence in 1496. Seven sultans of this dynasty ruled not only Telangana but the entire Telugu speaking land, including parts of present days Maharashtra and Karnataka. The Asif Jahis was a dynasty which ruled the kingdom of Hyderabad. The founder of this dynasty was Asif Jah I, and the final ruler was Usman Ali Khan. Total 7 Nizams ruled here. Telangana movement. The Telangana movement referred to a movement for the creation of a new state, Telangana, from the pre-existing state of Andhra Pradesh in India. The new state corresponds to the Telugu-speaking portion of the erstwhile princely state of Hyderabad. After detailed discussion and deliberation with the plurality of Telangana intellectuals, KCR announced the launch of Telangana Rashtra Samiti political party on 17th May 2001. On 29th November 2009, KCR had announced an hunger strike demanding statehood to Telangana. This acted as a spark to intensification of the movement. Then movement spread like a wildfire, with students, employees, people's organizations plunging into it. After several years of protest, the central government under the United Progress Alliances decided to bifurcate the existing Andhra Pradesh state on 7th February 2014. The cabinet of Telangana, lasting for almost a decade, this has been one of the most long-lasting movements in South India on 18th February 2014. The Lok Sabha passed the bill with a voice note. Consistently, in the general election held in 2014 April, the Telangana Rashtra Samiti emerged victorious, winning by 63 of the 119 seats, and formed the government. Sri Kalvakunta Chandrasekhar Rao was sworn in as the first Chief Minister of Telangana, and the Telangana state was inaugurated formally on June 2, 2014. Thank you, ma'am.
Over to you, Shelley, ma'am.
Oh, sorry. Thank you, Mubeen. Bahut hi nicely apne short brief mein hame history of Telangana bataya. Thank you so much. Now, the third participant is Kashish from GNG College. She'll give a detailed presentation on foods of Haryana. Over to you, Kashish. Kashish, are you there?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Are you ready?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
A very good morning to all my respected teachers and my dear friends. I, Kashish, pursuing my BSc Home Science first year and secretary of Ek Bharat Shresth Bharat Club of Guru Nanak Girls College, Yamunanagar, welcome all my counterparts of our paired state Telangana on this joint event. My topic for today is authentic Haryanvi foods.
Hina, please play the presentation. Hina, ma'am, you are requested to please play the presentation.
Haryanvi cuisine is like the people of Haryana, simple, earthy, and inextricably linked to the land. In Haryana, the emphasis is on food that is wholesome, fresh, and prepared with little or no fuss at all. Haryana, with its essentially agrarian culture, has retained simplicity in its cuisine. The land of rotis is an apt title of Haryana, as people are fond of eating different kind of rotis here. Wheat rotis are common, and so are bajre ki roti. In earlier times, rotis would be made from a flour of wheat, gram, and barley, a truly nutritious and healthy combination. Then there is a gochni atta made from wheat and gram flour. However, with the rising price of gram and barley, people prefer the comparatively cheaper wheat flour, thereby leading to loss both in terms of taste and nutrients. There is an abundance of milk and milk products in Haryanvi cuisine. People make butter and ghee at home and use this liberally in their daily diet. Homemade fresh butter is called nooni or tindi ghee and is churned daily in most homes. Buttermilk or chaj is a favorite drink and is an instant cooler for summers. Next slide, ma'am. Authentic Haryanvi dishes. Bajra aloo roti, besan masala roti, मिक्स दाल, हरा धनिया छोलिया, कड़ी पकोड़ा, अलसी की पिन्नी, मालपुआ, मीठे चावल, बाजरा खिचड़ी, भूरा रोटी, घी. नेक्स्ट स्लाइड मैम. पॉपुलर ब्रेड्स रोटीज ऑफ हरियाणा. बाजरा आलू रोटी इज पॉपुलर हरियाणा डिश ड्यूरिंग द विंटर मंथ एज बाजरा इज सेट टू प्रोड्यूस वार्मथ इन द बॉडी. आलू रोटी इज प्रिपेयर्ड विद स्मैश्ड पोटैटोज एंड वेरियस स्पाइसेस इन इट. बथुआ रायता मे बी सर्वड ऑन द साइड. बथुआ रायता इज अ रिफ्रेशिंग योगर्ट रेसिपी विद एडेड हेल्थ बेनिफिट्स. बथुआ और चिनोपोडियम लीव्स आर एंटी ऑक्सीडेंट्स एंड आर रिच इन मेनी वाइटमिन्स. To prepare this, chop bathua, cumin powder, red chili powder, and salt are added to it. It can be served along with almost all meals in Haryana. Besan ki masala roti is an Indian bread made with the dough of besan, gram flour, atta, wheat flour, and ghee with spices in it. Next slide, ma'am. Popular main courses of Haryana. Mixed dal is a protein-rich recipe in which various dals like chana, toor, masoor, and moong dal are mixed with spices and are cooked in ghee. The semi-crushed grains of the dal allow dish to have a rich and thick texture to eat the dal. Most people have dal with plain rice or jeera rice. Mixed dal is good for satisfying both your health and taste buds. Hara dhaniya cholia is an authentic dish of Haryana. Cholia or green chana is mixed with other vegetables like onion, carrots, and spices. Kadi pakoda. Kadi pakoda is a gravy made from sow yogurt and is thickened using gram flour. What makes the recipe unique in Haryana is that folks add fritters to the kadi pakoda, that is pakodas. It is perfect Indian comfort food. Singre ki sabji, it is a dried besan bean found in the state and is used for cooking this mouth-watering sabji. To prepare this vegetable, stir-fried beans are soaked overnight and then boiled in salt water for 15 minutes. They are then cooked on a pan with a few spices like amchur, mango powder, and berries. Yogurt might also be added to it. Next slide, ma'am. Popular desserts of Haryana. Alsi ki pinni is a sweet dish made from alsi, that is flaxseed or linseed, wheat flour, sugar, nuts, and ghee. All these ingredients are used to make a mixture, which is then rolled into balls. This sweet dish is also healthy as it is rich in omega 3 and iron. Mithe chawal are prepared using basmati rice, ghee, and sugar along with cardamom and saffron. Basmati rice is grown best in Haryana. This dish is very famous and is a must try. Malpua is an Indian version of sweet pancakes. They are fluffy and are served hot. It is made in ghee and served with rabdi, a condensed milk-based sweet dish. Next slide, ma'am. Popular meals of Haryana. Khichdi is had almost throughout the country. However, what makes Haryana khichdi so popular is that instead of rice, bajra is used. For preparing bajra khichdi, bajra is soaked overnight, then moong dal and bajra are washed together and cooked in a pressure cooker along with spices. Bhura ghee roti is a sweet savory dish made with bhura, that is a powdered sugar, ghee and leftover rotis. Haryanvis often indulge in this after a meal as dessert. Thank you for your patience and have a nice day.
Thank you, Kashish. Itna detailed pura presentation about foods of Haryana. I'm sure hamare Telangana friends ko kafi maza aaya hoga. So now, Arshia Fatima from Government Degree College for Women is our next participant. She'll take us into the realm of Telangana tourism. Arshia, are you there?
शैली मैम मेरा एक सजेशन है, अगर सभी स्टूडेंट्स जो प्रेजेंट कर रहे हैं वो प्लीज अपना कैमरा ऑन रखें ताकि बच्चे एक दूसरे को देख पाएंगे.
जी बिल्कुल.
जो भी स्टूडेंट प्रेजेंट कर रहा है प्लीज आपसे रिक्वेस्ट है कि आप अपना कैमरा ऑन कर लीजिए थोड़ी देर के लिए.
अर्शिया आप कनेक्टेड हैं?
यस मैम.
ओके प्लीज
गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन,
स्विच ऑन योर कैमरा प्लीज.
ओके मैम.
या वी कांट सी यू प्रॉपरली अर्शिया.
वन मिनट.
या ओके.
गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन.
गुड मॉर्निंग
मैम. I have to do screen sharing, so I can't.
It's okay. You can share your screen. Okay. But for initial starting, keep your camera on.
I'm Arsha Fatima. Okay, ma'am. I'm Arsha Fatima from Government Degree College, Hussaini Alam. BSc first year student is on here on behalf of Ek Bharat Shreshth Bharat program. Today, I am going to say you about tourism in Telangana. Telangana is the South Indian state. It has many tourist attractions, including Hyderabad. In Hyderabad, a city of contrast, Hyderabad includes an old word charm of its own with old city, Charminar, high-tech city and other areas lying in between the old and the new largest city and the capital of Telangana. Telangana is home for stately mosques and nicely bazaars lined parallel along swanky new office buildings and malls. It is these very contrast, these glimpses into the city's rich past with inherent promises of an even better future that make Hyderabad a city worth visiting, maybe even more than once. Its historic sites include Golconda Fort, a former diamond trading center that was once the Qutubshahi dynasty capital. On the Mosi River, South Bank, the Salarjung Museum has enormous wide range collection of global art covering several millennia. Chaumahalla Palace was built by Nizams, the princely rulers of Hyderabad from 18th to mid 20th century. Chaumahalla Palace is an opulent complex featuring courtyards and fountains. North of the river, the white Birla Mandir occupies the hilltop with views over Hussain Sagar Lake. Hussain Sagar is famous for its 18-meter high Buddha statue. On the outskirts, Ramoji Film City is a sprawling movie production center featuring audio tours, studio tours and a theme park. Proceeding towards the tourism of Telangana, another tourist attraction is Khammam. Khammam is the fourth largest city of Telangana. It is historically significant city. Khammam hosted many movements during India's freedom struggle. The Khammam Fort is a famous cultural landmark of the city and also popular tourist destination. It also has many religious attractions, including the Narsimhadri temple is situated on the hilltop and is said to have existed since 1.6 million years. There are many top places to visit in Khammam, such as Narsimha Swami temple, Khammam Fort, Palace Lake, Kaman Bazaar and Gandhi Chowk. Our another topic is Bhadrachalam. Bhadrachalam can be a refreshing place to visit with a sheer of instances from Ramayana, a glorious place of a vibrant river and mystical terrain and surroundings. One of the major attractions of Bhadrachalam is the Sita Ramachandra Swami temple. It attracts more than 40,000 people. One can visit Abhaya Anjaneya temple and River Godavari. And River Godavari, it is believed to be very holy. There are many other places to visit in Bhadrachalam, such as Papikondalu Hills, Parnasala Savari, and City Shopping. Then the next is Warangal. Warangal takes you back to the era of kings and queens with its beautiful historic sites and impressive natural beauty with Parkhal Lake being worth checking out. It is the fifth largest state in Telangana. There are many places to visit in Warangal. And there are many places to visit in Warangal, including Warangal Fort, Kakatiya Musical Garden, Kakatiya Rock Garden, Padmakshi Temple, Siddheshwara Temple, Laknavaram Lake, and the Zoological Park of Warangal. Thank you, everyone.
थैंक यू अर्शिया. हमें इससे पहले सिर्फ हैदराबाद का पता था, बाकी सिटीज का ना तो नाम पता था. थैंक यू सो मच फॉर योर प्रेजेंटेशन. अब हमें पता चला कि हैदराबाद के अलावा भी बहुत चीजें हैं तेलंगाना में देखने के लिए. थैंक यू सो मच. नेक्स्ट इज प्रियांशी फ्रॉम जीएनजी कॉलेज, हु इज गोइंग टू रिसाइट अ पोएम इन हिंदी ऑन एक भारत श्रेष्ठ भारत. Over to you, Priyanshi. Priyanshi, aap connected hain? Priyanshi? आरती मैम, shall we move on to
शैली मैम, मुझे लगता है yes yes I think we should move on to the next participant.
She is not there. Okay.
She is not connected.
No, she is. She is. I can hear Priyanshi.
Priyanshi is there. Okay. Priyanshi, are you ready?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Over to you, Priyanshi.
Okay, ma'am. Good afternoon to all of you. I am Priyanshi Saini, MSc Human Development final year student of Guru Nanak Girls College, and I am presenting a poem on Ek Bharat Shreshth Bharat program in front of all of you. And before I start, I would like to say a few words about my country. Anekta mein ekta is desh ki shaan hai, isliye mera Bharat mahaan hai. And now I want to start. Na koi Hindu, na koi Muslim, na ho Sikh Isai. Na koi Hindu, na koi Muslim, na ho Sikh Isai. Sabse pehle Bharat Vasi, aapas mein ho bhai bhai. Ek rahe hain, ek rahenge, yeh sabko samjhana hai. Ek rahe hain, ek rahenge, yeh sabko samjhana hai. Ek Bharat, Shreshth Bharat, Bharat ko phir se banana hai. याद रखो कभी न भूलो कैसे हम आजाद हुए, कितने चढ़ गए फांसी पर और कितनों के घर बर्बाद हुए. देश प्रेम की वही भावना जन जन में फिर से जगानी है. एक भारत श्रेष्ठ भारत, भारत को फिर से बनाना है. एक भारत श्रेष्ठ भारत, भारत को फिर से बनाना है. केरल हो, कर्नाटक हो, हरियाणा हो या राजस्थान, सब संस्कृति भारत की संस्कृति. हम रहे एक परिवार समान. कहीं किसी का अपमान न हो, कहीं किसी का अपमान न हो, सबको सम्मान दिलाना है. एक भारत श्रेष्ठ भारत, भारत को फिर से बनाना है. विविध रंग हो विविध देश हो, विविध रंग हो विविध देश हो, सबकी यही पहचान है, कश्मीर हो या जाट मराठा, हम सब भारत की संतान है। धर्म एक हो लक्ष्य एक हो, देश को आगे बढ़ाना है। धर्म एक हो लक्ष्य एक हो, देश को आगे बढ़ाना है। एक भारत श्रेष्ठ भारत, भारत को फिर से बनाना है। और विश्व गुरु के पद पर भारत को फिर से पहुंचाना है। एक भारत श्रेष्ठ भारत, भारत को फिर से बनाना है। एक भारत।
थैंक यू प्रियांशी, बहुत ही सुंदर शब्दों में आपने यूनिटी इन डाइवर्सिटी को एक्सप्रेस किया। थैंक यू सो मच। नाउ वी मूव ऑन टू नेक्स्ट पार्टिसिपेंट, नजमा बेगम फ्रॉम गवर्नमेंट डिग्री कॉलेज फॉर वुमेन। हर प्रेजेंटेशन इज ऑन द आईटी इंडस्ट्री ऑफ तेलंगाना। नजमा, आर यू देयर? नजमा, आप कनेक्टेड हैं? नजमा,
असरा मैम, प्लीज सी नजमा कनेक्टेड है क्या हमारे साथ?
यस मैम।
ओके, गवर्नमेंट डिग्री कॉलेज फॉर विमेन के स्टूडेंट से मेरी रिक्वेस्ट है कि प्लीज आप अपनी स्क्रीन शेयर ना करें। हम लोगों के पास आपकी प्रेजेंटेशंस हैं, हम शेयर कर देंगे जैसे ही आपका नाम अनाउंस होगा। So you can see presentation of information technology industry in Telangana on screen. Nazma, please start.
Nazma has messaged me that she is in the meeting, but maybe she is unable to. Nazma, what happened? No problem. She is unable to share it.
So, ma'am, you want to say she'll not be able to perform?
No, she just now she has a message that she is unable to present.
We are presenting her presentation on the screen, so she can just speak. अश्रा मैम, क्या
अनम्यूटेड
पार्टिसिपेंट चले?
बाय द टाइम शी सेट्स एवरीथिंग, शैल वी मूव ऑन टू आवर नेक्स्ट पार्टिसिपेंट?
यस शैली मैम, यू मूव ऑन टू द नेक्स्ट पार्टिसिपेंट, आई हेल्प हर अनम्यूट हरसेल्फ।
फाइन मैम, ओके। So our next participant is Priyanka from GNG College, who has prepared a presentation on biodiversity heritage of Telangana. Priyanka, are you ready?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Over to you, Priyanka.
A very good afternoon to all the teachers and my dear friends. I am Priyanka of BSc Medical from Guru Nanak Girls College, Yamunanagar, Haryana. Under the program of Ek Bharat Shreshth Bharat, today I am going to present my presentation on the topic Biodiversity Heritage Sites of Telangana. Biodiversity, basically the term which means the variability among living organisms from all the sources, including terrestrials, marine, aquatic ecosystems and ecological complexes. And we all know that our planet is currently facing the urgent challenge that it is loss of biodiversity. Today, to come up from these challenges, the government has made some biodiversity saving areas. Like today, we all are familiar with the term biodiversity heritage sites. Here, we are specifically going to discuss about the biodiversity heritage sites of Telangana. So, what is biodiversity heritage sites? These are the areas that are unique ecological fragile ecosystems, terrestrial, freshwater or marine, having a rich biodiversity comprising any one or more of the components. Ma'am, next slide, please. So here, the International Day for Biological Diversity, which is celebrated every year on 22nd May. The General Assembly declared the period 2011 to 2020 as a United Nations decade on biodiversity to promote the implementation of a strategic plan on biodiversity and its overall visions of living in harmony with nature. Ma'am, please, next slide. Now, I'm going to tell you about the state biodiversity symbols of Telangana state. Here, ma'am, next slide. We have some pictures which reflect the culture and traditions of Telangana state. First is a state bird called Pelapita, which is also called as a roller blue jay or Indian roller bird. And its scientific name is Coracias belangensis. But in our north side, it is known as Nilkanth. This was the first bird which was spotted by the Lord Rama before invading Lanka and vanquished Ravana. It has been chosen to put the Telangana on the path of victory. The next we have the picture of a deer jinka. Its common name is spotted deer, and scientifically we can say it as Antilope cervicapra. It is associated with Indian history, and a reference to the graceful animal was there in the great epic Ramayana. It reflects the mindset of the people of Telangana, as it is very sensitive and innocent. The third picture we have of Jami Chetu. This is the state tree. It is popular in Rajasthan by the name Khejuri. Its scientific name is Prosporus cinerea. The Pandavas have vanquished a large army of Kauravas only after worshipping this tree. They had hidden their weapons on this tree when they had been forced into exile in the forest. The last is a state flower which is called Tengdu. This scientific name is Tanner's Cassia. It is used during the Batukama's festival by women folk. Next slide, please. Now, if we're talking about the biodiversity of Telangana, it is very wide. It is known for its rich heritage fauna. It is rich with 108 species of mammals that include tiger, leopard, sloth bear, giant squirrel, four-horned antelope, pangolin, black buck, jungle cat, etc. Among flora, the state harbor a total of 2,800 taxa belonging to 1,051 genera under 185 families. They account for 16% of genera angiosperms known from India. Of these, 2,071 species belonging to 150 families and 796 genera are dicotyledons, and 729 species belonging to 255 genera and 35 families are monocotyledons. Next slide, please. So here we have the picture of Aminpur Lake. Aminpur Lake, the pride of Telangana. It is the lake in the Sangareddy district of Telangana. It is the first body of water in India to be recognized as BHS. It occupied more than 300 acres. Various residents and migrants, birds such as flamingos, egrets, cormorants, kingfishers, and home to 18 species of mammals, 166 birds, 45 herpetofaunas, 9 species of fishes, and 143 invertebrates are present in this lake. Next slide, please. At last, I just want to say that there is an urgent need to conserve the biodiversity, which is vanishing day by day. As we all know that today we are facing the deadly virus corona, which has already ruined the life of lakh of people. Somewhere we humans are responsible for this. I think we should do the little good things daily to conserve our nature. We can develop nature strategies for the conservation of sustainable use of biological resources. We can protect plants, animals, microbial and genetic resources for food production, agriculture of ecosystem, and one And one day, we definitely visit to Telangana to see the beauty of nature after this pandemic is over. Thank you so much for your time today.
Thank you, Priyanka. That was an interesting presentation. So now I again call upon Najma Begum from Government Degree College for Women. Her presentation is on the IT industry of Telangana. Najma, are you there?
Yes, ma'am, I'm there.
Najma, okay. Najma, can you please switch on your camera? Najma, aap sun pa rahe ho? Yes, we can see you now.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, are you ready, Najma?
Yes, ma'am, I'm ready.
Okay, over to you now.
Najma, your voice is not audible.
IT companies like Tata Consultancy Service, Wipro Technology, Infosys, Hyderabad stand in the second position by contributing 11% of national wide. Hyderabad stand in the second position in the country by contributing 11% of national wide IT export. Telangana government is aggressively setting up export oriented units. The IT industry has generated employment to 43,417 employees in IT and sector. Hyderabad has a right infrastructure and positive government policies in place to surpass the growth story of Bangalore in this sector. IT MNCs in the
Aarti ma'am.
Ma'am, ji ma'am.
Can we try Najma's performance later? Because I think her voice is not at all audible.
Yes, ma'am. I think it is due to poor internet activity at her side.
Let's wait ki connection aur thoda stronger ho jaye. Tab tak kisi aur participant ko bula lete hain dobara.
Theek hai.
Okay. We'll call Najma once again after a performance or so. Our next participant is Saida Nimra Fatima from Government Degree College for Women. She will talk about welfare schemes of Telangana government. Saida, aap hain? Aap connected hain? Okay. Are you ready, Saida?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Aap please apna camera on karengi?
Okay, ma'am. Good afternoon to all my respective teachers and students from both the colleges. Myself, Sayeda Nimra Fatima, I am from the MGSC second year. Today I am going to tell about the welfare schemes of Telangana. What are the welfare schemes have been launched by the Telangana government? First of all, the primary and the foremost objective of any welfare state is to sustain or improve the living standards of people. Social sector development is a gaining ground, especially in the context of human development. The concept of human development highlights the importance of bringing improvement in the social infrastructure, which was like education, healthcare, nutrition, drinking water supply, housing, social security, public investment in these social overheads ensures social justice and equality in the society. Promoting people welfare is the prime agenda of the Telangana government. Accordingly, a number of initiatives have been taken up by the Telangana government for the sake of the Telangana state peoples. The scheme which was launched by the Telangana government, sir. Ma'am, next slide. First slide, Kanti Velugu.
Hina ma'am, yes. Please move to the first slide.
Yes, ma'am, this only.
Yes.
Next, ma'am, next. Kanti Velugu. Yes, ma'am. The scheme is Kanti Velugu. The aim of this scheme is to achieve a blindness-free status in the state. The government has embarked on noble project to achieving avoidable blindness-free status in the state. This is started by conducting a universal eye screening for the entire population in the state, and this was the program launched on 15 August 2018. Next scheme is the Right to Bandhu scheme. This scheme is meant for the agriculture productivity and income of the farmers to enhance their agriculture productivity and income of the farmers. In this scheme, a government has allotted a 12,000 crore for the year of 2018-19. And by this scheme, the government gave the investment support to the farmers by providing them a rupees of 4,000 per acre per farmer in each season for their necessary requirements like for purchasing seeds, fertilizers, pesticides, etc. Next is the next slide. KCR kit. The kit, this is the scheme meant for the pregnant women. And this is only for that woman who give birth in a government hospital in the Telangana state. The kit has been given to the women after the born baby. The kit which was given to the woman contained necessary items required for the woman and the newborn baby. Under this scheme, a financially assist also provided to the baby and the mother. A rupees of 12,000 in three phases is financially assist. In case of baby girl, extra rupees of 1,000 is also given. Ma'am, next slide. Ma'am, next slide. Ma'am, next slide. Mission Kakatiya. Mission Kakatiya only, ma'am. Mission Kakatiya. This mission is aimed to improving the groundwater stable and reducing the power consumption by farm sector and getting higher yields. It is a program for restoring all the minor irrigation tanks in the state in 5 years to provide irrigation sources, and it is a flagship program of the state. As a result of this, as per the study, application of silt on palm field resulted in saving range of rupees 2,500 to 3,750 on fertilizers and pesticides, and also the yield of cotton increases 1,000 kilograms per hectare. Next, ma'am. Mission Bhagiratha. This is the mission on drinking water. The Telangana has started project on drinking water supply. It is also a flagship program of the state. The aim of this mission is to provide a safe drinking water to all villages in the state. Mission Bhagiratha started with the budget of ₹43,791 crore to provide a pipe water to households, nearly about 20 lakh in urban areas and 60 lakh in rural areas. Next one. Haritaharam. Haritaharam is also a flagship program of the state. The aim of this scheme is to increasing the green power of the state. By the scheme has started to increase the green field in the state. A total of 230 crore seedlings would be raised in the 3 years when the scheme is started. From that three years, we have raised the 230 crore seedlings, and it was started from the 1st of July, which was celebrated as a green week. And also the 50 lakh saplings would be planted in the GHMC also by this scheme. Next one. Kalyana Lakshmi Aura Shadi Mubarak scheme. The scheme was meant for the brides. Firstly, this scheme is only meant for the SC or ST women to distress their financial distress. A amount of 50,000 in one time sanctioned at the marriage of each SC or ST girls. But on the decision of the communities, the scheme is meant for all the minority community girls. At the time of the marriage, 51,000 to the bride will be paid. Next one. This was launched on 2nd October 2014. Next is the Asara Pension Scheme. This scheme is meant for the poor people in the states. The scheme, government as a part of its welfare measures and social safety net strategy introduced the Asara Pension Scheme with a view to ensure secure life with dignity for all the poor peoples. Asara Pension Scheme is meant particularly for the old and infant peoples with HIV and AIDS, and for widows and incapacitated beavers and toddy tappers who have lost their means of livelihood with their growing age. Next, land distribution to Dalits. This is the scheme meant for the woman. The 3 acres of land given to the SC landless woman, and along with this, the provision also given for creating of irrigation facility, other agriculture inputs. Next one. She teams. This was the scheme started on the briefly discussion, keeping rising incident of crime against the woman in the state, the committee has been set up. The committee has been set up by IAS officer Punam Malakonda to advise its measure to taken for the safety of women and girls. The scheme is given as she teams, as it meant for the women or girls. What was the team was doing? The team keep tap on event teasers and stalkers in crowded places and safety for the women. Apart from this, many schemes have launched by the Telangana government for the sake of the Telangana state peoples. Thank you.
Thank you, Saida. Bahut hi informative presentation ki aapki. Shall we call Najma once again? Najma?
Shelly, ma'am, I think we can call her in the end. We continue with the normal sequence now.
Fine, ma'am. Okay. So coming up next is Shivani from GNG College, who is going to perform a Haryanvi pop dance to give you a piece of Haryanvi folk dance.
Dance.
Shivani?
Yes, ma'am. Good evening, ma'am.
Ready?
Good evening.
Okay. Okay, over to you now.
प्रियांशी को ले
हो गया मैम मैं आ जाऊं दिख रहा तुम्हें इतने दूर तुमने तो बोला नहीं हो रहा अभी
फिर क्या लगा है मुस्कुरा रही थी
यू कैन स्टार्ट शिवानी
शिवानी आप दिखाई दे रहे हो हमें दिख रहे हो बेटा आप
स्टार्ट कर
जी बेटा आप दिख रहे हो
नेक्स्ट मैं बुलाना चाहूंगी अश्करी फातिमा ऑफ गवर्नमेंट डिग्री कॉलेज फॉर विमेन हु इज गोइंग टू सिंग अ सॉन्ग फॉर अस अश्करी आर यू देयर
यस मैम आई एम हियर
ओके 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 ओवर टू यू अश्करी
थैंक यू मैम ऑनरेबल चीफ गेस्ट एंड टीचर्स एंड ऑल माय डियर फ्रेंड्स गुड आफ्टरनून वन एंड ऑल Myself Sayed Asghari Fatima of BCom first year computer application from Government Degree Women's College from Hussaini Alam. Now I would like to present or else sing a song Tarana of my Bharat. Shall I start ma'am?
next. Yes, sure.
सारे जहां से अच्छा हिंदू सीता हमारा हमारा सारे जहां से अच्छा सारे जहां से अच्छा हिंदू सीता हमारा हमारा सारे जहां से अच्छा हम बुलबुले हैं इसकी ये बसता हमारा हमारा सारे जहां से अच्छा हिंदू सीता हमारा हमारा सारे जहां से अच्छा पर्वत वो सबसे ऊंचा हम साया आसमां का पर्वत वो सबसे ऊंचा हम साया आसमां का वो संतरी हमारा वो पासबा हमारा हमारा सारे जहां से अच्छा हिंदू सीता हमारा हमारा सारे जहां से अच्छा गोदी में खेलती है इसकी हजारों नदियां गोदी में खेलती है इसकी हजारों नदियां गुलशन है जिनके दम से रश्के जिना हमारा हमारा सारे जहां से अच्छा हिंदुस्तान हमारा हमारा सारे जहां से अच्छा मजहब नहीं सिखाता आपस में बैर रखना मजहब नहीं सिखाता आपस में बैर रखना हिंदी है हम वतन है हिंदुस्तान हमारा हमारा सारे जहां से अच्छा हिंदुस्तान हमारा हमारा सारे जहां से अच्छा थैंक यू मैम जय हिंद
वाओ बहुत ही खूबसूरत बहुत सुंदर आवाज करी थैंक यू सो मच नाउ आई वुड अगेन लाइक टू कॉल नजमा फ्रॉम गवर्नमेंट डिग्री कॉलेज फॉर वुमेन फॉर हर प्रेजेंटेशन ऑन आईटी इंडस्ट्री ऑफ तेलंगाना नजमा आप कनेक्टेड हैं आरती मैम शायद नजमा नहीं है
या दैट वाज व्हाट आई वाज आल्सो थिंकिंग मे बी शी विल स्पीक नेक्स्ट टाइम
ओके नो प्रॉब्लम मैम सो विद दिस वी कम टू द एंड ऑफ ऑल द परफॉर्मेंसेस बाय द स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ बोथ द कॉलेजेस ऑल द स्टूडेंट्स परफॉर्मड रिमार्केबली एंड आई एम श्योर दैट टुडेज इवेंट has definitely fulfilled its aim of enlightening both the sides about their respective paired state. Now, I humbly invite Dr. Abdul, Assistant Professor Urdu from Government Degree College for Women on the platform for a vote of thanks.
Thank you, Shukriya. Thank you, madam. Awaaz aa rahi?
Ji sir, bilkul aa rahi hai.
Okay. एक भारत श्रेष्ठ भारत के तहत आज हम सब एक साथ जमा हुए हैं ये बड़ी खुशी की बात है कि इसके तहत हम हरियाणा के कॉलेज जिसे हम गुरु नानक गर्ल्स कॉलेज के नाम से जानते हैं उनसे मिलने का एक मौका मिला मुझे बड़ी खुशी हुई कि हम दो कल्चर, दो जगह, दो स्टेट और इन तमाम को समझने का, दोनों के छात्राओं का आदान प्रदान और उनके बीच हुए वार्तालाप को सुनने का मौका मिला। मुझे बड़ी खुशी हुई। मैं मुबारकबाद देता हूँ गुरु नानक गर्ल्स कॉलेज हरियाणा के जो मैनेजमेंट हैं उनका, पूनम कौर अहलुवालिया प्रिंसिपल मैडम का, आरपी सिंह का और शैली मैडम का, जिन्होंने जो है आज एक ऐसा अच्छा और अद्भुत संगम जो है आज उन्होंने हमारे बीच रखा है। मैंने दोनों कॉलेजेस के छात्राओं को सुना, बड़ी खुशी हुई। खासकर जो है गुरु नानक गर्ल्स कॉलेज हरियाणा की दिशा, कशिश, प्रियांशी, प्रियंका और शिवानी का। मुझे और भी कहने में खुशी होगी कि आज कशिश के द्वारा जो है जो हरियाणवी फूड का जो पस मंजर पेश किया गया, जो थाली दिखी, वो देख करके वाकई में मुंह में पानी आ गया कि काश आज ये जो वेबिनार हो रहा है ऑनलाइन, ये ऑनलाइन ना होता और हमारे हुसैनी आलम कॉलेज के तमाम छात्र और यहाँ का तमाम स्टाफ अगर हरियाणा गुरु नानक गर्ल्स कॉलेज जाता तो शायद कि हम उन भोजनों का हम स्वाद ले सकते। बहरहाल बड़ी खुशी हुई। खासकर जो है बहुत दिन हुए बाजरे की रोटी खाए हुए और वहाँ का जो साग का जो कल्चर है, बहरहाल आज जो है वो हमें देखने का मौका मिला। बहरहाल हम यहाँ की और वहाँ की जो भाषाएं हैं उन भाषाओं को जानने का, यहाँ के और वहाँ के जो फूड हैं, खासकर जब आप यहाँ आएंगे तो शायद आपको बाजरे की रोटी, साग और सरसों का साग और चने का साग का स्वाद तो ना मिले, लेकिन आपको यहाँ की बिरयानी, यहाँ का हलीम और ईरानी चाय से हम आपका स्वागत जरूर करेंगे। बहरहाल मैं तमाम छात्राओं का, गवर्नमेंट डिग्री कॉलेज हुसैनी आलम और गुरु नानक गर्ल्स कॉलेज हरियाणा के तमाम छात्राओं को जो है बधाई देता हूँ कि उन्होंने अच्छा प्रयास किया है। रहा सवाल थोड़े से टेक्निकल फॉल्ट का, चूंकि हमारा ये जो कॉलेज है ओल्ड सिटी में है और खासकर जो हमारे कॉलेज जो कि गवर्नमेंट कॉलेज है और यहाँ पर जो है बहुत सारी पूर्व बच्चियाँ यहाँ पर आती हैं, 1400 बच्चियाँ हैं जिसमें से अभी हम लोगों ने जो है जब सर्वे किया था थोड़ा सा स्कॉलरशिप के हवाले से, तो मुझे बहुत अंदाजा हुआ कि करीब 300 से 400 बच्चियां ऐसी हैं जो अनाथ बच्चियां हैं, हमारे कॉलेज में पढ़ती हैं, तो बहुत सारी फैसिलिटीज जो है उनके पास नहीं है, लेकिन हम जो है धन है, खासकर वसुधा मैडम जो हमारी प्रिंसिपल है उनका हम जो है शुक्रिया अदा करते हैं कि वो अक्सर जो है फीस पे करने के टाइम पे जो है उन ऐसी गरीब बच्चियों का सपोर्ट करती हैं। खासकर मैं एकेडमिक कोऑर्डिनेटर, मैंने भी कोशिश की कि कम से कम एक फंड इस तरह का बनाया जाए ताकि इन गरीब बच्चियों तक जो है उनको पढ़ने का मौका दिया जाए। बहरहाल आपके और हमारे कॉलेज के मिलने से मैं समझता हूँ कि एक नई राहें खुलेंगी, कुछ नए कोर्सेज हम आप जो है हरियाणा के और हमारे यहाँ के कुछ नए कोर्सेज जो है जो हम इन बच्चों को दे सकते हैं, जो ज्ञान बांट सकते हैं, खासकर जो है एजुकेशन के मामले में हम बहुत कुछ कर सकते हैं। तो मैं चाहता हूँ कि दोनों कॉलेज मिल करके दोनों जगह की बच्चियों को जो है आगे ले जाने की कोशिश करें, क्योंकि बहुत कम ऐसा वक्त होता है कि हम इन बच्चियों को निखार सकते हैं। यही वो वक्त होता है कि जब हम बच्चियों को आगे बढ़ा सकते हैं, उनकी हौसला अफजाई करके उनको हम उनके मंजिल मकसूद तक पहुंचा सकते हैं। बहरहाल बड़ा अच्छा लगा। मैं दोनों कॉलेज के जो है स्टाफ का, खासकर जो है हुसैनी आलम का, प्रिंसिपल मैडम का और पूरम कौर साहिबा का और शैली मैडम का और वहाँ के जो और भी जो छात्र हमसे जुड़े हुए हैं, खासकर जो ऑनलाइन हैं और हमारे जो है इन दोनों कॉलेजों के प्रोग्राम का आनंद ले रहे हैं, उन तमाम का भी मैं शुक्रिया अदा करता हूँ। शुक्रिया, थैंक यू, धन्यवाद।
थैंक यू सो मच अब्दुल सर। ये जान के बहुत ही अच्छा लगा सर कि पुअर बच्चियां और खासकर अनाथ पुअर बच्चियों को आप लोग अपने कॉलेज में पढ़ा रहे हैं, उनको सपोर्ट कर रहे हैं सर। ये बहुत ही प्रेजवर्दी काम है सर। हमें और भी अब प्राउड महसूस हो रहा है कि हम लोग आपसे पेयर्ड अप हैं सर। और जरूर सर हम लोग कोशिश करेंगे कि आप लोगों के साथ मिलके सर ये बच्चों को आगे ले जाएं, इनको खूब आगे सक्सेसफुल बनाएं सर। थैंक यू सो मच। और सर जैसे ही ये कोरोना का पूरा सब खत्म होता है, डेफिनेटली सर हम लोग बहुत खुश होंगे आप लोगों का यहाँ वेलकम करके, आप लोगों को सरसों का साग, बाजरे की रोटी जरूर सर्व, जरूर कुछ ना कुछ ऐसा एक्सचेंज जरूर करेंगे सर। डेफिनेटली
जरूर, बड़ी खुशी हुई कि आप हमारे इस अनुरोध जो है उसको कबूल किया आपने, और हम चाहते हैं कि आप भी हैदराबाद आए ताकि हैदराबाद का जो कल्चर है वो आप देखें। बड़ी खुशी हुई, मैं भी चूंकि यहाँ का नहीं हूँ, मैं यूपी का ही हूँ, 2007 में मैं यहाँ भटकते हुए यहाँ आया था और सिकंदराबाद रेलवे स्टेशन पे उतर करके मैंने एक साहब से पूछा था कि मुझे चार मीनार जाना है, कौन सी बस जाती है, तो उन्होंने थोड़ी देर रुक करके मेरे चेहरे को देखा और आगे बढ़ गए। तो मैंने कहा हे भगवान, ये कौन सा ऐसा शहर है जहाँ पर जो है मेरे दुश्मन पैदा हो गए। तो बाद में पता चला कि गाँव का इतना जो है गैप है यहाँ पे, तो मैं समझता हूँ कि नई नई भाषाएं सीखने का एक अच्छा अवसर मिलेगा। बहरहाल अब तो मैं प्रगाढ़ हो गया हूँ यहाँ की गलियों से, यहाँ की भाषाओं से, मैं आप सभी का वेलकम करूंगा। और हम भी अभी तक, हमारी मैडम कह रही थी कि आपको हरियाणा जाना है, मुझे बड़ा डर लगता था कि हरियाणा जाएं और फिर क्या कैसे होगा। बहरहाल लेकिन आज आप लोगों के प्यारे चेहरे देख करके मुझे ऐसा लग रहा है कि नहीं, अब हमें हरियाणा आना चाहिए। वैसे दिल्ली में रहने का इत्तेफाक हुआ है, मैंने एमफिल जामिया मिल्लिया से किया था, तो दिल्ली में रहने का अच्छा अनुभव रहा है, वहाँ के हरियाणवी फूड खाने का भी मौका मिला है, लेकिन हरियाणा और हरियाणा के लोगों से मिलने का बड़ा कम मौका मिला है। समझता हूँ कि एक अच्छा अवसर है, हम दोनों लोग, दोनों कॉलेज के स्टाफ, यहाँ के बच्चे, वहाँ के बच्चे, दोनों मिल करके एक नई तरह और एक नए रास्ते की तरफ हम लोग बढ़ने की कोशिश करेंगे। थैंक यू।
बिल्कुल सर, बिल्कुल बिल्कुल। थैंक यू सर, थैंक यू सो मच। सो दिस मार्क्स द एंड ऑफ आवर टुडेज वेबिनार। आई ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ GNG कॉलेज थैंक ईच वन ऑफ यू फॉर योर टाइम एंड पार्टिसिपेशन एंड मेकिंग द इवेंट अ सक्सेस with the hope of conducting many more such programs in future to generate vibrance of mutual understanding and appreciation. Let us say goodbye. Once again, thank you all for your cooperation. It has been a great experience. Thank you and have a nice day.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, everyone. Now I request all the participants to please leave the meeting. I request all the participants to please leave the meeting so that I can close the meeting.
Thank you.